Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the SSIS Integration Toolkit for Microsoft Dynamics NAV. The NAV Toolkit is a high-performance data integration solution utilizing Microsoft SQL Server Integration Services SSIS capabilities. In today's demo, we will show you our software running in a SQL Server 2012 environment. If you are using a different SQL Server version, the interface might be slightly different. To get started, let's create a simple SSIS project. This tutorial will assume that you have already installed the SSIS bits. Otherwise, you would not see the SSIS project type here. In the Business Intelligence template, select the Integration Services project and give your project a name. Press OK to create the solution. SSIS is a platform that can be used to implement data migration and integration solutions using its drag-and-drop capabilities. To begin the SSIS implementation using our toolkit, we would first configure the Connection Manager to facilitate the connection to the Microsoft Dynamics NAV web services. Before getting started, we need to check a couple of things. We will first make sure that the integration setting in the NAV application is turned on. I will pull up my NAV application and go to the Marketing Setup page. Under the Synchronization tab, there is a checkbox to enable synchronization. Make sure that this is checked. We will now open up services. If you are using NAV 2009 R2 or earlier, you would check to see that the Microsoft Dynamics NAV Business Web Services is running. If you're using Dynamics NAV 2013 or later, you would check to make sure that the World Wide Web Publishing Service is running in addition to the Microsoft Dynamics NAV server. Now we can go back to SSIS and create a new connection in the Connection Manager area to establish a connection to the NAV web services. In the Add SSIS Connection Manager dialog box, select the Connection Manager for Dynamics NAV and press Add. In the General page, you would want to specify the NAV server where you will enter in the location of the Dynamics NAV web service. Choose the server version of the Dynamics NAV server that you are running. The default service URL value will be predefined for you according to the NAV server field, but you may provide an alternative NAV web service URL depending on your setup. In the authentication area, the username and password allows you to enter the user account information that you would like to use to connect to the NAV server. Once the server information and authentication has been entered, you may click the drop-down for the company option, which will list all the available companies that the user has access to. There is also an option to enter in a timeout value in seconds for your connection. The default value is 120 seconds. In the Advanced Settings page, there is an option to retry on intermittent errors. If this option is checked, it will attempt to recover from potential intermittent outages or disruption of service so that the integration does not have to be stopped due to temporary networking issues. We have designed this option so that it should only retry when it is deemed to be safe to do so. You may also enter your proxy server information if you are behind a proxy server. After filling in all the necessary information, there is the option to test connection. You may click this button to see if a connection to the NAV server can be successfully established. We can now close the Connection Manager. We will now go into our data flow view. Our next step is to use the data flow components offered by the SSIS Integration Toolkit for Microsoft Dynamics NAV. If you are using SSIS 2012 or later, you will automatically see these components. If you are using SSIS 2008 R2 or earlier, you would need to manually add these components to the SSIS Data Flow Toolbox. I will pull up the SQL Server Business Intelligence Development Studio to display this. Right-click on the toolbox and select Choose Items. Click the SSIS Data Flow Items tab and select the Dynamics NAV Source and Destination Component. Once again, make sure that you are in the data flow view to see these components in the toolbox. Let's go back to the SSIS 2012 environment. In the SSIS toolbox, you will see the NAV source and NAV destination components. The NAV source component can be used to read data from the NAV server, while the NAV destination component can be used to write data to the Dynamics NAV server. We will drag a NAV source component from the SSIS toolbox to the design surface. Double-click to open the configuration editor. Specify the connection manager. I will use the one we just created. Select the drop-down to retrieve your NAV objects. If you do not see any objects listed here, you would have to go to your NAV application to create new web service entries to add the necessary page objects. We can select the source object customer card. The batch size is the amount of records we would like to retrieve for each service call to NAV. There is an option to specify a filter criteria which will help filter the data accordingly. I will copy and paste my filtering criteria from my second screen. Page filtering also supports the use of SSIS variables. If we navigate over to the columns page, we can see the list of available fields for the particular NAV object that has been chosen. Notice that there is a refresh component button. This feature is used when you would like to retrieve the latest metadata. We will write the output to a separate text file. Let's drag a flat file destination component to the design surface. We would now configure the flat file destination component to write the data into. Now we can execute this task. All the data from the columns page of the source component will be migrated to the location in the flat file configuration. We will now look at the NAV destination component. To demonstrate this, a new data flow task will be created to illustrate the migration from a flat file source component to the NAV destination component. We will retrieve data from the text file in the first data flow task and write to the NAV server using the NAV destination component. Once the flat file source configuration is done, we will drag the NAV destination component from the toolbox onto the design surface and connect the upstream pipeline component to the NAV destination component. Once we open the destination editor, we will first configure the connection manager. Let's now select the customer card object. As you can see, there are four action types. There are the obvious create, update, and delete actions. The upsert action works by first checking to see if a record exists. If it does, it will perform an update. Otherwise, it will create a new record in the NAV system. The checking will be performed using the manually specified criteria, which will be explained shortly. For this demo, we will select the upsert action. There is a batch size setting, which by default is set to 200. In the case where we specified upsert for the action type, the batch size option is ignored. It will process one record at a time. Notice that when we selected the upsert action, a new upsert setting is displayed on the screen. This option allows us to specify how we would like to handle multiple matches that are returned by the component when performing an upsert. Let's choose the update all records option. Now we will navigate over to the columns page in the destination component and specify which fields will be used for upsert matching. As you can see, the fields are automatically mapped based on a name match. You can choose to map or unmap a field depending on your business requirement. To select the fields that we would like to manually specify, we would select this box. It is possible to use a combination of multiple fields. However, for this demo, I will select the name field for the upsert matching. It is also important to note that if you have any unmapped fields, the checkboxes will be disabled. Note that there is also a refresh component button, which will update the component to the latest NAV metadata. The last page is the error handling page, where there are three error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is fail on error, where the entire data flow will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the redirect rows to error output, where the error output will contain the failed records with the extra columns, error code, error column, NAV error message, and error code description. The ignore error option is generally not recommended. There is also the enable columns for default output section, which you can use to enable or disable the additional columns in the destination component's default output. Key gives you the newly created NAV records ID, and isNew tells you if the record is a newly created one or an existing record that has been updated. We have now completed the configuration of our data flow task. We will right-click and execute the task. This concludes the demonstration of our SSIS Integration Toolkit for Microsoft Dynamics NAV. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to contact us.